Let's try this again, shall we? Yeah, I don't know what happened. I apologize, but the video just suddenly ended. I don't know. It did not give me any indication that it was going anywhere. So, let's try it again, shall we? So once again, we are here for Zap Chat on a Wednesday, and we're talking about attention span and the lack thereof that's going on in the world. Hi again, Brie. I'm sorry about that. I have no idea what happened. It just ended mysteriously on its own. So, yeah, this is going to be one of those nights. Okay. Attention span theater. Here we go. All right. I know. I was confused too. All of a sudden everything went dark and I was like, what happened? So, okay. So what I'm going to do tonight is I'm going to run through, I'm not going to go into like too much about like how bad it is that we have this low attention span, but I am going to talk about how, it's not necessarily bad that we're on social media if we can find a balance. So, which is really what I'm all about. I'm all about, you know, this attempt to find my own balance in life. And I have noticed, it's funny because this whole thing came up. I've been resisting getting on TikTok for the longest time. Mainly because I don't like the reports that come out about how bad it is for young girls and you know, how toxic it can be and blah, 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 blah. So I was just like, yeah, you know, I'm not even gonna go there. Right. But I've been talking to people and, you know, I want to make a big impact with my coaching business. So people are like, well, you know, TikTok is a way to reach a lot of people that might actually need what you're offering. And I'm like, I don't want to, but I did. So I did, right? I got on TikTok and oh my God, I realized how easy it is to just keep scrolling, right? Have you noticed that, Brie? I don't know. You've probably been on TikTok longer than I have. And I'm just like, whoa, that is so creepy how easy it is just to like keep going. And I was like thinking about one of the guys that I am learning from. His name is Sean Cannell. He runs a company called Think Media. It's all about YouTube and making your living on YouTube, right? And he says you have to, what is it? It's probably not going to be a direct quote, but it's basically, if you are consuming more than you're creating, then you're not going to go anywhere, right? So the idea is to create more than you consume. And that's the balance that I kind of want to take, like kind of a journey that I want to take you on tonight, Brie, since you're here. and we'll talk about ways that in this culture where we have gotten to the point where our attention span is so low, there's a whole conversation that can go into like how that benefits people that we don't want it to benefit and all that kind of stuff. But that can be a conversation for another time, because right now I want to talk about how we can strike that balance and learn ways to expand our focus and become stronger and have a means of developing a better focus. Okay. So the two things I want to talk about tonight, of course, is meditation. Meditation and different types of meditation are excellent ways of increasing your focus. For one thing, one of my favorite ways, if I'm feeling myself being super scattered during the day, I go into meditation and I do the one where I'm counting my breath. And it's usually just something simple at first, like inhale four, outhale four, inhale four, hold four, and then outhale for six. Outhale? Is that the word? Why am I feeling that that's really weird? Aw, thank you for all the lovely emojis, Bree. So, exhale. That's the word. I said it was going to be one of those nights. Thank you, Bree. Exhale, outhale. What the heck is that? Yeah, I actually had just finished watching some my daughter's favorite thing right now is watching an anime called Demon Slayer, and it's really good. And it's on a certain arc of the story right now that it's really, really good. So we watched an extra episode, and I was not ready for it because I was like, oh my God, it's almost seven. So sorry if I'm a little bit scattered. I apologize. It's kind of special going from anime Demon Slayer to mindfulness, and we do. So, okay. So once again, I'll go through just simple meditation techniques and mindfulness that can help us develop a better way to focus, and it would be a practice that helps to develop over time. It's like a muscle that you have to exercise, right? Okay. So step one in almost all things is awareness, right? If you find, like I found when I first started looking at TikTok stuff, like literally I was like, yeah, okay, the first few seconds of that video, if it didn't catch my attention right away, scroll, scroll. And I was like living the meme, right? And I was like, whoa, okay, so there's some awareness there. And so that's where mindfulness comes in as the first step. So whether you're looking at social media or listening to a lecture from an instructor, or trying to, learn something online, even, let's face it, just having a conversation and listening to our loved ones, right? If we've noticed that the attention is going away as we're trying to, I'm going to use having a conversation with somebody because that's a really important one, right? We all want to be heard, and we want to be present when we're talking with our loved ones. So, if our loved one isn't entertaining us, we should still be present and work with them in communication. So, first step is acknowledging that there is an issue, and you don't have to like stop a conversation and be like, "Oh, I'm sorry, I can't listen to you right now." But just consciously bring your attention back to the person in front of you, right? One of the ways that I do that is I stop letting my eyes wander, and I make sure I either focus on their eyes or on their nose or on their lips. I know that might sound weird. Or sometimes, if you don't want to seem like you're being weird, looking at a point just above their head. And that way, they don't think that you're necessarily staring at them, but they know that you are looking at them and you're able to stay focused. Like I like to look at the third eye, because it's a very friendly place to be. So that's mindfulness. And you can, oh, thank you. Bree says, yes, that's so smart. Thank you. Yeah, it's very helpful for me, because sometimes, like when my daughter is gushing about like this video game Genshin Impact, I love her, so I want to be present for her, even if I don't need to know all the stats of all the different characters and all that kind of stuff that she's really interested in and gushing about, right? I know it makes her happy to talk about it, so I need to be there for her. So mindfulness and really just bringing my eyes to the task, focusing on her, that makes it so much easier than to really actually get into what she's saying. It's if when we consciously decide, everything's a decision, right? When we consciously decide that, yes, I am present. Yes, I am going to be here and pay attention. It's amazing how much more interesting life gets. I'm not kidding. It's really, really cool. So that part has helped me a lot in communication with people. When it comes to interacting with inanimate things, like, you know, social media, whatever. If you find that you're just like doing this, put the phone down. Because you're not really there anyway, right? There's something else that you're avoiding, possibly. Or just acknowledge that I'm really bored and let yourself be bored. Because some of the greatest, most amazing creative things come from being bored. And when we're not allowing ourselves to just sit there in the nothing, right, of boredom, then it stifles our creativity. It doesn't allow us to have moments of inner reflection, which, admittedly, that's why a lot of people are addicted to social media, because they're like, I can look at everybody else's life and not think about mine, right? But that's when you have to make the decision, you know, like, do I want to live like this, or do I want to be better? And do I want to, yep, that's what I tell my kids. Think. Yes. Think. Because really, it is that decision. Ooh, when I said that, it was 12 minutes into this. Anyway, it really is that decision-making moment when you need to decide, or you don't need to, I hate to say need, when it's your opportunity to decide which way you want to go. Yes. Mm-hmm. When they're bored? Absolutely. It's... a lot of it, some of this actually came from some of my my parenting experience, and when other parents were like, oh yeah, you know, because my daughter's been in a Waldorf-inspired school since nursery school, and their whole thing is let the kids be bored. That's when they'll be thinking the most. That's when they'll come up with the coolest shit, you know? And I've seen it in action. You know, it's just like, okay, I'll tell a little story one time about my daughter. It was the most amazing thing. I was sitting there. I think she was four. Yeah, she was four. And I was sitting folding laundry one day. And she was off in her room doing her stuff, right? And then all of a sudden, she comes running in. And she's topless, and she's got this thing wrapped around her waist that looks kind of primal, you know, and she leaps from the ground to the chair, the seat of the kitchen chair, and you know, she's four, so that's a pretty big leap, and she comes and she starts doing a haka. I swear to God, she starts doing, I dance for the warriors. I dance for the people. And she was just like doing this thing, and she was doing the and everything. I was like, where the hell? I was so freaking happy. I was like watching this example. And then she ran across the room to the fireplace, and she jumped again, and she started doing this thing again, and I was like, wow. Okay, either my kid... I know, right? Lol. I swear, I was like, okay, either my kid is reliving a past life, or, like, we did go to Hawaii when she was two, or it was just, like, that time alone that she had in her room enabled her to think back even to when she was 2 years old and like recall this. So like I said, it's either a recall from when she was super, super little, or a past life thing. My son just asked, is that the girl we did the meditation with? It is. Hi. Yeah, so that was an amazing moment. And so now scale that to you're an adult, right? And usually you're all in for doing the marathon Netflix thing or social media thing or anything to really stop yourself from quiet space. So letting yourself get bored can be a super powerful position to be in, because there is that emptiness, and when there and nature abhors a vacuum, right? So when there's emptiness, it gets filled, and it can either get filled with thoughts that can help you heal or help you to become more aware of areas of your life that you want to heal, or areas of your life that you're super proud of, or areas of your life that you want to explore, which is super cool. Because, like Einstein said, imagination is more important than intelligence. And that quietness is something that gives you that space to imagine, right? So, yeah, that's one of my, I don't know, this is just kind of coming off the cuff, but the next thing I want to teach is a meditation that I use when I have been super scattered and super like no focus whatsoever. And these are coping mechanisms I've had to teach myself, because I'm not officially diagnosed ADHD, but I was late in life self-diagnosed, and I've got all the things. So, and that is something that I'm actually actively in the process of trying to heal within myself, because I do think that that's possible to do without, for some people it's totally possible to do without medication and extreme measures and stuff like that. So, this is my favorite get focused, get energized meditation. If you want to follow along, you are more than welcome. So I'll just give you a minute to shake things out. Ugh. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Get comfy. Stretch a little bit first. Oh, man, my shoulders are always so tight. Is there a massage therapist in the house? All right. It's not a very long one. What I do is I do kind of like what I mentioned before, where I do a four count inhale, I hold it for four, and then I exhale, not outhale. I exhale for six. And the reason that my exhale is longer than my inhale is because, one, it gets rid of more carbon dioxide. You're laughing at me, Brie. No. I love it. Please do. So yeah, one of the reason or it's one of the reasons that I do a longer exhale than inhale and hold is because it gets rid of more carbon dioxide. So you're getting more oxygen when you are going through the process. So I'm going to start with four and six and then eight. So I do three sets of that, and then I do some another thing that I'll show you, and you can follow along. So, all right. Now this is just a breathing meditation, so we'll start with this part, and then there's going to be a moment where I'll ask you to lift your chin a little bit. Move your eyes So like you're as if you're looking up at the ceiling, and you'll put the tongue at the roof of the mouth. Yay! Oh, I'm so glad all of you are there. And then after that, there's another little breathing thing that we can do afterwards. And it all comes together pretty quickly. Okay. All right. Take a starter breath in and exhale. And take a breath in and one, two, three, four, and hold. Four, and exhale. Two, three, four, five, six, and inhale for six. One, two, three, four, five, six, and hold for six. One, two, three, four, six, and exhale for eight. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and inhale for eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and hold for eight. Eight, and exhale for 10. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and blow out. And a big breath in. And sigh it out. All right. Now lift your chin a little bit. And you can either keep your eyes closed or have them open, but look up like you're looking at the ceiling and put your tongue on the roof of your mouth. Yeah. And we'll just sit in quiet meditation for about 30 seconds while we're doing that, okay? And go ahead. And if you find your focus drifting, just bring yourself right back. Feel the tongue on the roof of your mouth and keep looking up at the ceiling. And take a really big, deep breath in and sigh it out. Flicker your eyes open. And now take your hand and use your thumb and your pinky. Put one on one side of your nose, okay? And what you're going to be doing is you're going to be inhaling through one side, and then you're going to use the other finger to block the other one, and you're going to be exhaling through the other one. And usually we can do, we'll just start with like 13 rounds. And usually this can go on for a really long time. Yeah, you can do this kind of breathing. And what this kind of breathing does is it helps to align both sides of your brain. You're going in and out, and then in and then out. Okay. So don't be afraid if you have any like snot or anything. Life happens. All right. So let's do 13 rounds of in, out, in, out. And then we'll see how you guys feel. Okay. So we're going to start with the thumb on the right side of the nose. Okay. Inhale through your left, and then we'll exhale through our right. Ready? Inhale. Exhale. Now you're inhaling through the right and exhaling through the left. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. One more big breath in and sigh it out. Go ahead and wiggle, let out any stuff that came up. Sniffle your nose if you have to. Whew. It always gets me going up in here. So I would love to hear any observations that you might have about that. Yeah? Yeah, I feel much more focused and grounded right now. I can actually feel my brain. The kids liked it. Yay! Yeah, it's a really good, especially the nose one. That one. it feels really, really good, and it helps me to feel really balanced. And I can feel the oxygen in both sides of my brain, like, cruising and being more excited. Yay! I love that. I'm so glad they feel good. That's great. Awesome. So, yeah, those are my two key, suggestions for if you're feeling scattered or unfocused. Really the point is not to exclude. Yes, made me a little more awake. Yeah, right? Yeah, definitely. Me too. The idea here is not to say, you know, social media bad or that, you know, any real negative thing or anything. It's just about finding that balance. And when you feel that you're not at your best, these are the things that I do to help me kind of get back on track. So, did you have any questions? Or I would love to hear like anything more that you would like me to discuss on like future Zap Chats or even my Meditation Monday. Just so that I know I'm, you know, I got my finger on your pulse as far as what you want to learn. And yeah, so if you can't think of anything right now, please feel free to do so in the comments later. And if you are watching this on the replay, please hit comment hashtag replay so that I know that you guys are watching, because I love it. So hugs to the babies, Bree, and hugs to you too. Thank you for showing up. I really, really appreciate it. I love your support. Nazir wants to know what medication is. Medication is like when the doctor gives you a prescription for like pills or anything like that. Medication can also be herbal remedies. Depends on how you use herbs. They can be used for healing, in which case they're your herbal medicine. Okay. Sorry. Totally misunderstood that. What meditation is next? sorry. On Monday, I think I'm going to do a meditation on self-love. If that's what you're asking, what the subject is. Oh, no, it's okay. So my next meditation, because we're in the month of love, which every month is the month of love as far as I'm concerned. So with Valentine's Day coming up, I wanted to do a meditation on self-love and connecting with your higher self and that kind of good stuff, because that's really the best kind of love to have, because then your cup runneth over. It's my favorite too. So awesome. I feel good. I'm like, yeah, I can now. I think I can do some work. All right, well, that was all I had for tonight. Thank you so much again for coming, and I am super excited about all the stuff that's coming up soon. So Magical Monday meditation is going to be all about self-love. I love you too, Bree. And be on the lookout, everybody, for, I'll be making some more posts about my upcoming masterclass in March. Oh, I'm so excited. I can't wait. I love you. And I hope you have a wonderful evening, everybody. I love you. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Have a good night.